Okay, so I got all new filters all made up now. All fresh filters. I'm putting some tissue in between them so I don't scratch them. I guess I forgot to do this one. The only reason I'm putting this to this video, because I gave away all the rest of the filters that I had, so I'm making new filters. And these are those HD sunglasses filters, and I've got this one, and there's green, blue, and yellow contrast in this one lens, right? This one, you got red, so, and then this one's like dark gray. For some reason, these HD sunglasses, I won't say they're the best. I'm trying to struggle for the word. They're not the best because our eyes can use all these different contrasts. Everyone seems to be a little different. Some people, when I use the red filter, people will chime in and say that they see it better, right? Or I'll get a new subscriber based on a video done in red. Then hundreds of other people could come in and look at that same video with a red filter on the camera, and they don't think much of it. They're not seeing it. It doesn't stand out at them. They have a hard time breaking up the collage into all of the images. Then someone else comes along that might be okay with red and then won't be okay with gray. The gray is making everything darker, and the one I just had on the camera, this one before, was a bottle one that I made out of a bottle. Now, I had a green one as well, and the green bottle worked really well, and I am going to keep going with the bottles using the glass, but obviously it's thick, right? It's thick, so I got to look through it when I'm picking through the broken glass. I'm looking around saying, what's thinner, what's thicker, and then I look up at it if I see any imperfections in it or if I can't see through it that clear. So it's been trial and error with the pieces of glass, but I'm getting there. I think I'm going to end up finding, I've got a blue bottle. I think it was some kind of vodka or something that's in it, but it's a blue bottle and it's fairly thin. If I get that and I break that one up and make some filters out of it, I'll be doing really good. But right now I made these filters. Now you can see what I'm doing. It's just quite simple. All right. And I'm going to go for this one for this particular video. If it goes well, we'll see what happens here. Let's see how it rips. Might have to go in here. Oh, there it goes. Okay. And I already cleaned it. Looks like I got some glue on there, but yeah, that's it. So this one is the corner one. So another thing is each camera, I don't like these cameras with the corner lens. But oh well, we're gonna do that. I'm gonna go back to this. And we're gonna do this. Maybe I'm gonna go in a little bit too. There we go. I think I'm gonna go straight up. Straight up and then this way. Make sure that I can see everything. Was kind of an angle on the last one, somewhere around there. Because it doesn't matter. In the true creator's work, there is no up, down, left, right, backward, forward, in or out. So it doesn't really matter to me to show all of you the imagery. But how much of it I get to go through my camera at any given time is a big deal to me because I don't like wasting my time. When I go back to remaster the videos, it's much easier. So that's it. Those are the filters, and I got enough made now. Maybe I'll go this way. I have enough made now. Should be all set. There we go. So I'll go right there. I can see it all coming through now. So over the next few minutes, it'll get better. Let's see. this tripod doesn't have any way for me to spin the camera all the way around and do 360s. I don't like that about it. I may have to change something on it. But yeah, here it comes. Here we go.